fiance. Now that a man chose you, your life begins today. Make him a happy home.
Every guy dreams of finding a girl who looks like you. come true. Would leave me speechless like you always do. But now we're wide awake. We've got some plans to make. Let's take some action, baby. So baby, give me your hand. I've got some dreams to achieve. I've got a future away. It's time to get serious. Time to get serious. I'll be quite house back I'll be ready.
Yeah.
Three kids at least, just like the Kennedys. Is where our lives begin. Just where do you
fit me in?
I'll break it down now, baby. So baby, give me your
hand. Here's my hand, here's my hand.
I've got some dreams to make true.
We know that things can be true.
I know you'll understand.
No, it's worse. It's Warner's brother.
Wait a second. This is the kind of girl Warner wants. Someone serious! Someone loyally! Someone who wears black even when nobody's dead! I have a completely brilliant plan! What you want, Warner, what you want is me.
She's applying.
Apparently.
It says here she has a 4.0 average.
Yes, in fashion merchandising.
And she scored a 175 on her LSATs.
There's even a letter of recommendation from Ellen DeGeneres!
I'm arguing Miss Woods is entirely unqualified, but look at her! Is this the face of Harvard Law?
Multiculturalism!
Excuse me?
We could have missed her. For reasons of
multiculturalism!
Exactly!
Gentlemen, get a hold of yourselves. This is Harvard Law, not Tinder. Don't you look at that. She didn't bother sending in a personal essay.
How? This third personal essay! What do you want? What do you want?
Security!
What do you want is right!
Who are you?
I'm what you want. Harvard, I'm the girl for you. And to prove it's true, we all live here on Jackson.
Thank you!
This is what the woods inspires. Everyone admires her. So what do you say?
This is not a personal essay!
No, an essay so boring and so much to stop it. So we're nearing line right here. Maybe three miles to get the help. Woods to join your chosen few. Harvard was one is right in the map.
Do you believe?
I do!
Do you believe?
Welcome to the hallowed halls of Harvard Law. I know firsthand how hard you've all worked to be here today. So let's go around the circle and share a bit about yourselves.
Aaron Schultz. I wrote Fulbright and a Rhodes. I write financial software codes. But that's a challenge I have grown. How many yachts can one man own? Some say that I'm above this creep. Somehow I don't lose that much sleep. Why bother with false modesty? Harvard's the perfect place for me.
It's a person good to know.
Welcome to Harvard.
What's up, Joe?
Sandeep Agarwal-Padamana, but you may call me your majesty. In my country, my word was law, but then I flee because of stupid coup d'etat. But here I learn, I make new friends, and soon return in bulletproof Mercedes-Benz.
Pretty impressive, good to know.
Welcome to Harvard.
Ignore that. It's simplistic, and it's dumb. Only some of you will turn out sharks, just some. The rest are chum. Our topic is blood in the water. Kids, it's time you face. Law school is a waste. Oh yes, unless you acquire a taste for blood in the water. Dark and red and raw, you're nothing until the thrill of the kill becomes your only law. Mr. Schultz, hypothetical question, would you be willing to defend the following banker accused of fraud? A kind old grandma took her savings and she sent it off to your client. All she had saved when she was born. Well, he promised to invest it, but he spent it on prostitutes and heroin and porn.
No, I would not want to take that case.
Wrong, this one's a win unless you're lazy. Grandma's broke, she'll have some hat from legal aid. Put her on the stand and call her old and crazy. Your guy goes free and he can get you high and laid. Look for the blood in the water. Read your Thomas Hobbes. Only spineless snobs will quarrel with the morally dubious jobs with blood in the water. Your scruples are a flaw. Miss Poops, another hypothetical, would you be the right lawyer for the following client? Say they offer you a bundle for defending a famous hitman for the mafia. Seems he missed his chosen prey, killed a nun, and drove away, running over drinking puppies in the street.
What? You don't think I'd defend him because he's a typical man?
Oh, you lesbians think you're so tough. Oh dear, I fear my comment has offended. Hard to argue though if you're too mad to speak. Your employment will be very quickly ended when they see how your emotions make you weak. So what's my point? I run a $1 billion law firm, and I hire 4 new interns every year. From this class, I will select 4 young sharks of my respect, and those 4 will have a guaranteed career. Do you follow me? So I want to see what?
Blood in the water.
Exactly. Let the games begin. More of you will win, but just those 4 that adore. So, yes.
Blood in the water.
So fight and scratch and claw. Yes, miss.
Woods and woods.
Someone's had their morning coffee. Would you summarize the case of State of Indiana being heard from your reading, please?
Oh, I wanted to answer the puppy question.
But I'm asking you about the assigned reading.
Okay, who assigns reading for the first day of class?
You've got guts, Miss Woods. Miss Kensington, let us say you teach a class at Harvard Law School, a position that you're justly proud about. But a girl on whom you called hasn't read the case at all. Should you let it go?
No,
or...
I throw her out.
All right, then. You heard your classmates. You have just been killed. She cut your throat, so grab your coat. Yes, you've got guts,
but now there's still your blood in the water.
And if you return, be ready to learn. Or is that unfair? Oh wait, I don't care. That's just how I roll. In life as in school, with beer and shock and awe, you're nothing until
blood in the water.
The thrill of the kill,
blood in the water,
becomes your only law.
Hey, what's coming out? Listen, I just picked up one's first year too. It's awful, but your law career is not over.
Law career? So not the problem. Look, I need to get back into class with Warner. Can you help me?
Yeah, just come back tomorrow and make sure you've done your reading.
Okay. Excuse me, but why would you do that to another girl?
Do what?
We girls have to stick together. We shouldn't try to look good by making each other look bad.
I didn't make you look bad. You just weren't prepared. Try opening a law book sometime, but I should warn you, they don't come with pictures.
I'll give you two ladies a moment then.
Aren't there girls going wild without you somewhere?
Hey, Ella.
Warner, thank God you're here.
Ella, I'm sorry.
Sorry for what?
Warner, isn't there something you would like to share with Elle?
Do you know her?
Yeah, Elle, this is Vivian. She and I went to boarding school together. She's my girlfriend now.
I'm sorry, I just hallucinated. What did you say?
He said that I'm his girlfriend.
Girlfriend?
Oh my God, you're making me sick!
Really? make me a brunette.
Do you know the number one reason behind all bad hair decisions? Love?
You're lost without your love. Your heart's on the floor. I can help you. I've been there before. I need to relax. I just put on some tracks. From this CD I bought for the store. Isn't that relaxing? It's called
thank you.
studies and worrying about Callahan's internship.
You can say that again. Thank you. Oh, you two need to gel yourselves. Angel.
You do know that Whitney's father is next in line to be Speaker of the House.
So you said.
Just think of it. Future presidents may be in this very room. I'm gonna go check out Robert Coleman and convince him that he must join our study group. Apparently, the summer house is three houses down from Justice himself.
I'm gonna go get another beer.
Oh my god!
I'm a stranger.
Well, then, what's the costume?
Can a girl shake things up?
I mean, yeah, but are you avoiding some good going out? Ew.
Guess you never asked.
Which now ranks as one of the biggest regrets of my life. Man. I still can't get over the fact that you're here at Harvard. Back at UCLA, I never would have guessed it. Sometimes I miss the old days. Those party senior year, I thought we ruled the world.
Funneled all that beer, I held your head when you hurled.
We were like gods back then, walking among God and men. Tell me, why can't it be that way again?
Fools don't just. We could keep on dreaming them here.
Wait, what?
It's senior year, but funner! You've got your future all planned.
Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
What if I'm standing there too?
We don't know what we do.
I'm here because I understand.
I'm sure I understand.
I'm here because I'm serious.
Yeah, you look real serious. Think that you have a chance of getting that internship, right? You get kicked out of class, like, every day.
Of course.
Hell, everyone in that class wants that internship. No one more than me. It's a guaranteed career before you even have a job.
Hello, Elle. You're looking fluffy, as usual.
Oh. Hello, Vivian. Thanks for the great tip on the costume party. I see you came as last year's sample sale.
Whoa, you have to ace that course to get that internship, and he's not called C-minus Callahan for nothing.
Warner, I'm completely cognizant of both those facts.
You're not going to make it through the semester, let alone get Callahan's internship. Even if you keep going and going and going.
Ew.
Face it, Bunny. One of these days is not like the other. Someday we'll nominate Supreme Court justices, and you'll... tan. Run home, Hell, and change out of your skank costume.
Oh, is that what you see, Vivian? How unfortunate! Because I'm Gloria Steinem at Undercover circa 1963, researching for her feminist manifesto, I Was a Playboy Bunny! Are you actually calling Gloria Steinem a skank?
Who's called Gloria Steinem a skank?
She is! Period!
Okay. I grew up in the Roxbury slums with my mom and a series of bums, guys who showed me all the ways a man can fail. I got through law school by busting my ass, worked two jobs in addition to class. So forgive me for not being at your tail.
Oh, well, excuse me, just because you've got some kind of chip on your shoulder.
You know what? You're right. There is a chip on my shoulder, as big as a boulder. With the chance I've been given, I'm gonna be driven as hell. I'm so close I can taste it, so I'm not gonna waste it. Yeah, there's a chip on my shoulder. You might wanna get one as well.
I'm sorry, but that sounds highly negative.
Hey, when you're wearing glory and privilege, you have to work twice as hard. I want my sweatshirt back.
Wait, two jobs plus law school?
I haven't slept since 1998.
Seriously, how do you do it?
Well, I don't go to parties a lot. Not good use of the time that I've got. Can't spend hours doing my hair or staying in shape.
I don't spend hours.
But I know it'll all be worthwhile when I win my first school group trial. Goodbye, my mom, that great big house out on the cake.
Well, that's so sweet.
No, that's the chip on my shoulder. I hug my mom and told her, with the chance I've been given, I'm gonna be driven as hell. Though I can't take the day off, I just think I can pay off. You need a chip on your shoulder, little Miss Woods, comma L. You drink a lot of Starbucks, don't you?
Oh, it gives me energy!
So you can stay up all night studying?
What?
Study. You do, study, don't you? You wear those law books.
Come on!
shampoo, and conditioner in one.
Are you ready?
How do we
know, Judy scares the crap out of me!
That's okay! Channel that fear and tell yourself you are a strong, independent woman. You must be reunited with your dog.
Anyone who bakes their dog a birthday cake deserves nothing less.
Just have little bones on it!
And that kind of devotion cannot be ignored.
You know what? It is not easy to find dog-friendly chocolate substitutes! Dewey!
Crap, not you again. All I get your fat ass off of my property.
I want to see my dog, Dewey! I got a right! I bet you didn't even know it was his birthday today!
Well, too bad, Jellygut, you can't see it. Best decision I ever made was throwing you out.
Can you believe I lived with that for 10 years? Cheapskate never even got me a ring.
Oh, they lived together for 10 years.
Of course, Emmett, you're a genius. Do it!
Now,
my love fade away as my love fade away. Thank you.
Miss Linda. I'm Evan Forrest, co-counsel with Skinwell, Zelowski, Fox, and Callahan. These four entered the Freedom of Harvard Harvard Law, and we're here to live up your legal defense. Incidentally, my mom credits you with her nutcracker, but, her words. Anywho, we want to discuss your case and go over a few options. We want to free you as soon as possible so you can get your message back to your fans.
That's all I want. This should be easy.
Great. Callahan briefed you on your meeting, but there's a significant amount of evidence against you. To free you, the jury will need to hear an outline.
Not gonna happen.
Even though we can save you?
Yep. Put me on that stand. I will be forced to lie.
Okay, Miss Windham, but if you can't give that alibi, you should accept a plea bargain.
And admit to something I didn't do?
Well, but the plea bargain you get out in a couple years. That sounds reasonable, right?
Reasonable to do time for my husband's killer. Not really.
She's tough.
Yo, sister!
Yo, I'm not related!
I need to defend someone who knows I'm innocent. Get out of here, all of you. Guard!
Ooh, is a girl with loyal friends and true. Ooh, ooh, has a bond as strong as crazy glue. Who can sound the call and sisters all come through? Ooh, ooh. Delta Nu, 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 Delta Nu, 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 you are a Delta Nu.
Sorry, I need you to tell me the alibi.
Well, I can't because I gave Brooke my word. Having
but it sure would help.
Work with me. We can free Brooke the right way, the noble way.
I'm not interested in nobility right now, Elle. This isn't a Lifetime original movie. I'm more interested in saving Brooke's life.
No, you're not. You're more interested in impressing Callahan.
Well, then my impression will make me associate.
By jeopardizing the client's trust in our integrity?
Well, when you put it that way.
Exactly, you butthead.
My word means something, and I know yours does too.
No one's called me a butthead since the third grade.
Maybe not to your face. Come on, let's get out of here.
Why do you always have to be right?
I don't have to be. When I'm with you, I just am. Hey, you want to impress Callahan? I can help.
Okay, yeah.
Listen, I love your scruffy vibe. The casual Friday is so not in Callahan's vocabulary. And you have to look the part if you want to get ahead.
Elle, didn't your mother ever teach you not to judge a book by its cover?
She did. And books with tattered covers stay on the shelf.
Gene, thanks a lot.
Hey, this isn't a perfect world. You think people haven't judged me my whole life? You think it wasn't a good idea to make maybe my new pink?
No, that was a good idea.
No.
Where are we going?
You trust me, don't you?
Yeah, of course.
Don't stop now.
What is this place?
It's called a department store.
It's beautiful.
Thank you. Getting better.
Riley has been grilling Nikos, Argentacos, this Windows pool boy all morning. The waters could get dicey. Let's hope the defense back to floaties. Maybe?
My God, Evan, is that you?
I was just shopping.
Chalk one up for Al.
Evan, you look sharp.
Mr. Nikos, could you clarify for the court exactly what your duties were as a pool boy?
Cleaning the pool.
And could you explain what exhibit A is?
That was my uniform. Yes.
And what was your relationship to the defendant?
Brooke and I were lovers.
No further questions.
He was your lover?
Oh no, a detenu would never sleep with a man in a thong. I just like to watch him clean filters.
Unbelievable, you're all making me look like an ass up there. Your Honor, I request a 10-minute recess.
I'm so sorry, I'll take
this
outside.
Why didn't I know about this disaster?
Hey, it's a setback.
It's Mountain, Emmett.
Paulette, what's up?
Elle, I just had a call to tell you! The bandit snap worked!
I might have broken Kyle's nose, but I got to spend 4 hours with him in the ambulance and in the ER. It was the most romantic time of my life.
Paulette, that is so great. Look, I told you, the bend and snap is infallible unless the guy is gay or something. I gotta go. Bye.
Run!
Depending on the time of day, the French go either way.
You see, they are European.
such an affair with Miss Wyndham has been going on for
2 years.
And your first name again is?
Nicholas.
And your boyfriend's name is?
Carlos.
Excuse me, I misunderstood. Did you say boyfriend? I thought you said best friend. Carlos is my best friend.
You bitch!
Where I know.
wrong. We'll fix it. We'll fight it.
Emmett, please. There's no reason for me to stay.
What about love? I never mentioned love. The timing's bad, I know. But perhaps if I made it more clear that you belong right here, you wouldn't have to go. 'Cause you know that I'm so much in love.
Okay. got you out of baggage.
Oh, thank you! From Kyle Pino Blue! Where's the beast came from?
Redden.
Thank you.
Thank you, Miss Bonfante. Now, Miss Quinton, would Exhibit B's pattern be similar to your own?
Yeah.
And one more time, you didn't see the murder or hear the gunshot because you were aware.
In the shower!
Thank you.
Miss Hoops, would you step into the shower, please?
Idiot. You can get a permit
for 48 hours.
Exactly! Why would you activate the perm's emollient like lovely and completely ruins it? It's the cardinal rule of perm maintenance. Your perm is still intact, so you couldn't have showered that day. Why would you lie about being in the shower? Why would you lie about not hearing the gunshot? Why did you let light be colder than my dad's new arm candy wife?
I didn't mean to hurt my father. I didn't mean to shoot him. I thought it was Brooke coming through the door.
Oh my god.
Oh my god!
Oh my god!
Oh my god!
Oh my god!
Oh my god! Oh my god!
Hold on! Bad enough that I'm in a John. A bird's pussy. You're free. And we apologize.
Oh my god! It's a dream come true!
I just knew I could count on you. And now I'm feeling like a suction on my thighs.
We still love you!
Well, they've barely begun, I'm hardly.
I think we all pretty much think about the show 24 hours every day. And I would like to thank all of you for making my first show with the JWU Players amazing and for all your hard work. So I would just like to point you out, our producer, Hannah Sylvester. Our production manager, Char, Brecher. Our set designer, Sam Brenner. Our costume designer, Kiera. Not least, our director, Kelsie Reynolds. She has literally become my best friend and someone I can lean on and go to for anything. And I truly owe our friendship to this production, having spent many hours and many days together. You've shown me the ropes, and I hope I can one day be as a great director as you are. So good luck with your endeavors, and thank you so much.
Also, Ryan is a freshman and our assistant director.